You know, before today, I would have said I'd seen everything. Now I know I haven't seen a damn thing. Now, even if what you're saying is true, Elizabeth Keene still has a lot to answer for.
Doesn't matter now.
Well, we'll see if your wife agrees when she's serving felony time for perjury, not to mention facing an indictment for kidnapping, witness tampering, obstruction.
You can make all that go away.
Prosecution could still charge her with murder.
I told you she didn't kill anyone.
They will argue that she acted in concert. She didn't stop you. She knew that the harbor master would contact the police. She wanted him to die. At a minimum, she was an accessory after the fact.
She had no intent. I was the one who made the decision to act.
Yeah, so you say. The harbor master would have saved you. Why kill him?
To protect her.
The woman you spent the last 2 years of your life betraying? Someone you lied to, spied on, sold out, and betrayed? A woman you married as a job? She held you prisoner.
She wasn't thinking clearly. I needed to do something or she would have gone to prison.
You're in love with her. I won't even try to express how twisted that is. Okay, Mr. Keene, or whatever the hell your name is, if you want to fall on your sword for this woman, so be it. I will recommend that Agent Keene not be charged with the murder of Eugene Ames. But as to the other potential charges, I'm allowing the grand jury to proceed. Officers, find a seat for Mr. Keene and the pens until further notice.
Wait, listen. I will make a confession. I will give you a full deal. But you have to promise me that you leave Liz out of this.
That deal won't happen.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I told Mr. Connolly you...
Fine, Rosemary. Get him out of here.
Well, well, well. Reverend Wright said that Maine Justice would be sending an attack dog.
You're out of your mind. I mean, the Beltway's been saying it for years, but you really are out of your mind.
Well, in 30 years on the bench, I've learned their bark is far worse than their bite.
Not this time. What did you do, Richard? What the hell did you do?
I conducted an in-camera hearing, which I have every right to do.
You have no right, and you damn well know it. You're not cleared to hear national security cases. We have a FISA court for that, and you're not on it. Period. You compelled two federal agents to divulge national secrets under threat of imminent incarceration.
They violated my order.
To hell with your order! Your order was a per se violation of the Espionage Act, the Patriot Act.
Intimidation, threats. This is the way our government works. I'm supposed to just take your word for the fact that this case involves national security.
That's right. You're a superior court judge, Richard. This case is so far over your head it'd make your nose bleed. You intentionally access classified intelligence without authority. I should have you arrested right here and now.
Smiling Tommy Connolly. You always were a smug bastard.
And you were always a paranoid, self-righteous prick. Your Honor.
Here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna quash this subpoena.
Yeah, and if I don't?
You will. In everyone's career, there's a crossroads, Richard. A moment where what they'll say next will define their lives, decide their future.
This is task force really that important to you?
I don't know what that is. And neither do you. You crossed the line. I'm willing to move past it.
And who knows? Maybe one day when I'm AG, we'll get you on a real court.